you know, the only reason I even made a video of Magoo, Creepy McGee, is because it's just another character of somebody else who does show their face on YouTube behind another mask. And it's time for the big picture. I'm not gonna accuse who I think it is. Like, you know, if it's like, I'm not gonna accuse, like, for instance, I'm not gonna accuse John from Denver for being Ronald McGoo, Rodney McGoo, McGee, Rodney Franklin McGee. I'm not gonna accuse him of being it. I'm not gonna accuse John Quentin Wise of being Rodney McGee's other character, because it doesn't even sound like him, you know? Because it's not like anybody can change their voice at any given time. And it's not even like people are skilled way more than I am with even being able to do characters with different face masks and voices and stuff. So I'm not going to do that. But what I am going to do is say that I should have left work earlier. The guy would have got there earlier, damn it. I hate seeing the red line. I see the red line. Oh my goodness. About 41 minutes. It's terrible. Absolutely terrible. It says 7:59 I'll get there, but it'll be more like 8:10. 4 minutes faster. If I get off there, go around there, hop on there. I love dead stops. But the point is, Magoo is an easy character to do, because it's just like, it's just that you just do a hillbilly sound and change it up a little bit. But what the big picture is that, let's say, all right, let's say there's one person on YouTube, and that one person has 20 different characters. Some of them are famous, some of them are no name. Some may have a face, others may not have a face, they just have a voice. Like McGee. McGee's logic and whatever he talks about, I only watched him a couple times because he drops my name and talking shit, but knowing damn well that it's just another character of an agent. It's not even, the shit he's saying doesn't even, it's not, he doesn't even believe it. It's just what he's reading to say, the script. I don't know how long ago all these, because if you're 20 different characters on YouTube, you got a lot of time on your hands. And knowing how time is intertwined with the past, and how things are always not what they seem, some of these videos could have been done years ago, but yet it ties in exactly to today with what I'm saying, because my life is being watched on a flat screen up in heaven, that they're able to see everything I've already done, every decision I've ever made, every corner I go to, they'll be watching you. I'm stalked at every angle, every which way. tested and harassed. And even the ones that I see harassing me get harassed. So gang stalkers, gang stalking, gang stalkers. I've seen it. I've heard it in the Bible, where Christ had seen the lost sheep. They have no shepherd. It's somewhere along the lines where they're harassed and being harassed or something along those lines. In other words, even the gang stalkers don't get away with gang stalking just sheep. Or do they? I could be wrong. It could just be. Yeah, okay. So here we go. Here we go. Right before that roadblock, Robin. You want to make fun of me, Robin? Here, too. We're going to block the road for you, dumbass. I'm getting off. I'm getting out of here if I can. But I probably can't. Yeah, this is more of a accident. Accidentally on purpose, these things happen. The one thing I'm missing from all this, yeah, I can laugh at it too, John from Denver. But I still got to go to work and deal with this bullshit in the morning. It's either that or get up early. I lost sleep because I stayed up last night. Because I believe that certain people on this planet, they already know what I'm gonna do, so they already watched my video, but they know that it's gonna be funny. So I might as well make it, even though I know I already made it before. So the point is, things aren't that funny because, you know, when you're retired, when you don't have to do a damn thing. I mean, I don't know what it feels like. At some point, I will. I can only imagine waking up. I can only imagine at the moment, because I'm dreaming it up. Now, you can't be this damn funny and still have a job and go back and forth to work, damn it. Magoo. What a character that is, man. John, if that's one of your characters, that is a damn good one. I mean, he needs to go, for sure. And that's the whole point, is whoever has that character, you're out of here. Matthew, out of here. These characters that people have, these, what Steve and James would call scumbags. These scumbags, they need to get the hell up out of here, because they're doing no good. It's like my father's house. There's a bunch of thieves, and these thieves are all part of one person. So if one person has, let's just say, I'm not going to go 20 because that might be too many characters, but let's just say that one person has 12 characters or 13 characters. Each one person has 13 characters because they're all playing Jesus. Therefore, they're going to have 12 disciples and they're going to pick. They're just going to come up with their own, you know, like one character is cousin It, John Wise the Third, with no nose hairs, or one of them will have some hair on the one nose, and then the next week, or no, it won't have, yeah, there you go, it won't have any nose hairs until it's pointed out, and then 2 days later, it'll have these long strands just in one nostril. The hair is wild. Yeah, the look is just like, you know, the look of the character itself has this, I don't give a F, I'm lazy, I could just sit home all day and play with my cats, kind of a theme. And then let's say you have another character and his name is Jacob Israel. And then this Jacob is, he's well known, he has a muscle body suit. And he does the Italian thing, you know, like that. So that would be one of the characters. And then, because that would be pretty funny, right, John from Denver? If you had like 13 characters, and one of them was McGee, the other one was Quentin Wise, and then the other one was Jacob Israel, and then you have, it would be funny also if you were Stephen James Deshaun. And multi talented with your acting skills. I don't know how you change the voice up. Maybe you got a voice box. Maybe, being John Denver, I would assume that there's, you know how the skull and bone system is? I think what happens is when you die, or when you leave your first state, or however that works, the AI technology is something that is just added into your throat, and it's a computer, a chip, and it's adjustable, and you can basically adjust it with your mind, like whatever, you know how you can change your voice however you want, up, down, high pitch, low pitch, you go from, you know what I'm saying, to whoever and whatever. So you can do that, but it's more, or maybe you guys are just so damn good at changing your voice that you don't even need a voice box. You can just do it just like that. And then to have all these other characters, and then you got a Creepy McGee character, and then you have a Matty Yahoo character. And all these people, basically anybody that's come against me is going to go down. And they're going to, because what's going to happen is, well, Matthew Daly, obviously he was caught, but it's all script. Matthew Daly didn't really try to pick up a little boy. Maybe he has in the past. Maybe that's why. Maybe he's turned from it. Or regardless of whatever it is, he has the teeth. They're spaced out. It could be a fingerprint of the spaced out teeth. But he has horse teeth, so he can look like. Because the horse malarkey that comes out of his mouth about me and the personality of being a jackass, he looks like a jackass. And that was the purpose of it. Coming in riding a donkey. Riding a jackass. Coming into town riding a jackass. I mean, that was my triumphal entry in the YouTube platform, because Matthew Daly was the top guy at that time to do that job at that very moment. That's who he was. Everybody knows the character of him. So there you have it. And then, considering 6 years ago, he crucified me with every degrading, pretty much, word that he could say, insulting my intelligence, saying my intellect is not that high, you better believe it. I'm not calling you dumb or anything like that, but you are not. You're a schmuck, Robin. You're a schmuck. And And I was only 11 months old in one day in the YouTube platform. It's like, you know, the YouTube world is like a, it's like dog years. I'm really 49 years old, 48, 47, 49-ish, because each 7 years is like, it ages you, or each year is like 7 years. But on the platform itself, I didn't know anybody. I didn't know what I was doing. I had no clue about people wearing masks. I thought, I didn't even know what a troll was until I got trolled. And then you had Trolling for Truth, the Satyrs. I wouldn't be surprised if Tim, no, not Tim, Jethro Satyr was up next, John from Denver. Because he came at me pretty hard. But again, from back then, who was behind the mask of Tim and Jethro Satyr? The Satyr twins, Satan twins, Satyr, Tim and Jethro, rockers. It could have been Barack Obama and Joe Biden, for all I know. Because the people that are the presidents, again, that's not what they look like either. Everything is an act. Everybody, Skull and Bones is a vain show. When one character dies, like Prince, he just, whoever Prince is, whether that's Lucifer himself, I don't know how many characters Lucifer would have, but what else you got to do? It's all about entertainment. It's all about laughing, having fun, joking around. Lucifer loves to lie. Well, the thing about Stephen James is, in the beginning, I'm drifting off a little bit, but I'll get back to Magoo and the characters that gotta go, and that's the whole point. Basically, if I drift off too far, the summary of what I'm trying to tell you is, all these characters are being cleansed out of one person, and they're being snipped off like a branch being, like a tree being pruned. These are the characters that somebody had from the beginning, and they're all dying out because the YouTube platform is getting cleansed, like mega clean. It's getting just wiped out with all the dirt and scum and shit piles and scumbags. But my main question is, when is Stephen James gonna stop acting like I'm the devil? Unless if I am. Huh? When is he gonna stop? When is he gonna admit that he's the devil and I'm not? Because the devil is the accuser of his brethren. And they twist scripture. So the way Steve's character is, he twists the scripture, saying that I am the accuser because I accuse him of being like the top Luciferian United States gang stalker, or I accuse him of having the world script in his hand, or I accuse him of being the top three in controlling what happens here on planet Earth. And all these accusations are true, but I can't prove it, so I become the accuser. Because you can't prove, you know, why would I be messing around and you know, lying about or coming after someone who's a poor suffering servant in Michigan that's just been trying to live his life, and here I come along harassing him. Like, that's how that's supposed to look. But again, I don't know how many other characters Steve is. Usually the rule of thumb is, whoever you show is who you are. Jonathan Cleck does the same thing. He shows other different characters on the mainstream news. So whoever you guys usually show, you're just showing your other character, because why else would you draw attention to anybody else besides yourself? So that's what's disappearing from the table here. Is the characters that they do no good. So with all those characters, some of them are famous, some of them aren't. Some of them have superior body suits and voices, and the McGee's of the world, they don't. And they'll never get in front of the computer, the camera. I remember a long time ago, I thought, man, I got Stephen James DeShawn to get up from behind the computer and show his face. Well, I didn't realize back then that these face masks are just, you can't buy them. That's the thing, you can't actually buy them on the market, because these are custom designed. Stephen James's face mask is supposed to look like he's more stout than his fellas. Unless he's actually a physical human being on Earth, because I heard Lucifer is a human being. And then so is Christ. So Christ is a human being on Earth, which means Lucifer would be, I don't know, maybe Lucifer is his twin. Like literally from birth, somehow it's amazing how you would know ahead of time. This child here is going to be born, and he's going to be the savior of the world. Oh, and his twin brother, he's going to be the wrecker of the world. He's going to be the one that ruins the entire... He's going to be the one that everybody says, is this the man right here? Is this him? Is this the man that caused all nations to tremble? Stephen James DeShawn. Is that him? Lucifer's human name? I mean, if that's the case, man, I am in trouble, because I've been coming against Lucifer this entire time. Can't he just crush me? Can't he make my life a living hell? Hasn't he already done that by gang stalking me endlessly? Sending these demonic spirits in my direction. And here I am thinking it's all separate people. So let's think of the people. Let's think of the ones that have come against me. Matthew Daly was the first. And then recently, he's on the Chris Hansen show. And it's about child predator trying to pick up a 15-year-old. And he wasn't denying being gay. He was just saying that you can't prove that I was looking to do anything with the 15-year-old. I assumed he was 30, and he figured, you know, if you want to come over and smoke, you know, if you're cute and you come over and smoke, then that's cool. So he's just going down that road. And again, I don't even believe that story, because it's all an act, but it's part of the gig. It's you have to die. In other words, your character has to die out. Because think about however many people seen, if you don't know, or if you follow Matthew Daly, and you paid attention to him like 6 years ago, and he was your mentor, and you followed him and you were agreeing with him because he attacked me, and then you're thinking, yeah, Rob, well, you're a liar because Stephen James Deshaun, his job was to deceive everybody, because the truth showed up on YouTube, and the idea is to stomp out the truth, kill it, crucify it, slay it, bury it. So it gets buried for 3 years, three days, three nights. It gets buried, and then my job is to just dig myself out of the pit. Make a hole so I can put out my SOS signals and to rise up from the dead, because everybody left me for dead back then. And the main rising up from this hellhole was on 3/23/2023. That was the main tangible evidence of reaching through time, is what I did. I reached through time. My mind came up with an idea to record U2's songs and walk through the art museum and used imagery as a video. Before I thought of that, there's no way that I could possibly even have thought what happened was going to happen. There's no way that I can think I'm going to go in there and I'm going to make my videos line up with their footage from 30 years ago. And then for that to even take place, it's like if I died 30 years from now working for a living, God doesn't exist. That's just what it would be like. If I had to keep working and keep just doing it, it's either that or yeah, God, you exist, but you must be the devil, because how can you not compensate somebody for doing all this work, this spiritual work, this time travel work, this legitimate actual miracles being displayed? I can go in an art museum today if I wanted to and record a Rolling Stones album, and I can make all the imagery line up with it, because I don't even have to do anything. All I have to do is just know where to go, know what to do, know how to do it, and then do it. So here's how I can make miracles. I know what to do. What is it that I know what to do? I know that in order to produce a miracle and to say it before I even do it, the steps involved is I have to record the imagery that I'm showing you with my own eyes, and I have to also record somebody who's famous, a rock band, and then put that together. Where to go? Pretty much I can go anywhere, but it's more tangible to go into the art museum. I could also go to Forbidden Drive, Wissahickon Park, like I did with the Scorpion video, with the Shadow, with the Who's Gonna Ride Your Wild Horses video, and Dream On from Aerosmith. I can also do that. So the place to create a miracle really isn't anywhere besides wherever I want it to be. And then the proof is that I can do it, and then it's there. Look, I even when I was testing the X app to make sure it's working correctly, and I was playing through the 13 songs that I was going to play in Art Museum on 3/23/2024. There was a scene that I was recording with Bono, the very first song, where he's standing there with his arms up and his jacket out. There was a scene that I recorded with the X app. I deleted it because it was only a test. But he still used that test in the video with the jacket scene that I didn't put up, because it was only like a 5-second clip. And I wasn't trying to have any of it line up because I was trying to save it for the art museum. But yet it still did. And so it just proves I can go anywhere and anywhere. All I got to do is just record whoever's video I want. And because it's on the X app, the X recorder is where the future, it's where the future is. It's where bands from the past can line up in that present moment where I'm at. And then in the very near future, I can put it together and show you how it lined up. And then show whoever the principality of the airwaves, basically. I can show Lucifer that, hey, I caught up to you. Here you go. I know that you took my footage from before and you're lining it up. And the only frustrating part is driving back and forth to work still. Because if I didn't have to, the amount of things that I can still produce day in and day out, it would be endless. Endless entertainment for everybody. Endless. Because you know how that feeling is, Jonathan Kleck? You know how that feeling is when you see the thing that I'm showing and it's there and it just happened and I'm able to show it over and over again and again and again, like an avalanche, like a flood. It creates a new feeling. It's like a Holy Spirit feeling. So that kind of stuff can be done if I was someone like John from Denver. If I ain't had shit to do and I act like I'm at this job site with I got the forklift soundtrack in the background, the lady over the intercom. I would get different masks and I would do my characters as well. Because that shit is fun when you can put it together. I don't even know what made me think of how I did it last night. It's just, I didn't have, it's like I did it quickly too, because I got work today. I didn't want to stay up all night. And thanks to you, John, this is why I'm in traffic right now, because I needed to sleep a little bit longer because of your request to make you laugh. But it was kind of like a layover that I did with the hillbilly or with the cowboy. I'm sure I'll do it again. I'll find another character. I like the one without the teeth. And then I'll wait for Magoo's response. I wonder if he'll even laugh. Probably not, right? You got to stick to his character. It's so funny, the goofiness of the characters. How they try it. It's like they try to sound like they're putting me down, but they're raising me up as they act like they're putting me down. They're making me more famous than what I am, just by name dropping nonstop. I don't know how many people have called me by my full name. But Stephen James DeShawn's the one that started it. And then John Quentin Wiles, third, he wants to say the same damn thing. And John from Denver. John Denver. See, that's the thing, John Denver. You know, being John Denver, you obviously have more money than you need. It's not even about money, it's about just access. People know who you are, you can go. Or, the corporation knows who you are. You can do what you want. I can't do what I want. Wouldn't you love to help me out, John Denver? To help me out to be able to do whatever it is that I want. I can travel anywhere. I can go and meet anybody at any given point in time. You want to hang out? Here, I'll be there in a couple hours. Hop right on the airplane and get there. Or, the quick underground submarines train station that can just fly there real quick. However you guys get around underground. Because the characters that everybody is, like, let's say, you're John Denver, you do your show, you get into your limo or whatever it is, and then next thing you know, you change your character, and then you just leave and go, you're a regular person now. You're a regular person, you can go do whatever you want, and then whenever you're looking for attention, you just hop in your John Denver mask and walk around, and people will know that you're John Denver. But that Magoo's character, I can't say that it's him. Because he didn't actually say his name. It sounded more like Andrew Pardon at times when he was talking, the one that got caught stealing the Pokemon cards. But nevertheless, his face, and you can see that his eyes are also covered in a thick contact to cover his eye color. To be like shit brown. But the face mask that the guy has is made to be... It's kind of a mixture between... it's almost like a... I don't know what mixture is, just a creepy ass face. Like a stone cold nose, like a soulless Michael Myers type, but not intimidating. Like a Michael Myers / Derek from A Glop of Truth mask. So that would be funny if Derek from A Glop of Truth was next on one of the shows that you guys have set up, like the Cops show, the Chris Hansen show, like Hoarders show, Tyler Mullen would be another, that would be a good one, because he really came at me pretty hard too. Tyler Mullen, Justin Michael, Jethro Sater, Boldly, that would be a good one for Boldly to come up next. Even though he had already done his burning his nipples scene 5 years ago. I mean, that was enough to... But can you imagine the people that followed Matthew Daly? And if there is anybody, like real people out there that... was paying attention to me and then him, and then you believed him and left me, and then years later somehow my video pops up in your algorithm with Matthew's face, right? And then you're like, what the hell, who's Robin? I remember. And then you watch that and then you see that Matthew got locked up for doing what he did, and he's loves the Lord and he just wants to get back to reading his Bible. Well, if he was reading his Bible and he loves the Lord, he would know that homosexuality is a sin in the Bible according to your belief system. So therefore straight hypocrite. Straight hypocrite, pointing me out as if I'm the lying agent when he's the lying agent. If you ever see somebody out there with my face mask on, acting like they're me, trying to get me in trouble, just know it ain't me. It's exactly what I would know it is. I'm sure there's a Robin Henry Tees mask out there. There's probably a bunch of them. And people probably go around doing some stupid things with those face masks, or even to each other. Some sick stuff, I'm sure, if that's the case. I thought about buying a mask. I seen one that was about $160. I don't know, I thought about it. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll look into it. Just to do some more. Because I don't know what else am I going to do with videos. I've already done them all. I already did 33 of them in the art museum. With the imagery that these videos have up, the money that they made, the gazillions of trillions of dollars, and here I am month to month. Just trying to make it by going back and forth, back and forth. But thank God for that, because I learned a lot of the Philadelphia landscape and everything in between. Is it over?